Now today we are going to demonstrate the heart, how the heart looks like grossly or how it is located in the animal body. So this is the heart, bovine heart, big one. So this heart is suspended inside the thoracic cavity and by the help of the pericardium. So this is the pericardium, this is the pericardium, the sheet like pericardium, okay. Then this heart, the location of the heart is in the always in the middle mediastinal space. You know, the whole thoracic cavity can be divided into three parts mainly in the midline. It is known, that is the space between the two pleural sacs. Pleura is the covering of the lungs. Just like imagine two balloons. In one balloon there will be right lung and another balloon there will be left lung. Balloon is the nothing but the serous membrane and it is the pleura, pleural sac. Now in the thoracic cavity, on the left side, the left lung is located, and on the right side, the right lung is located. And the space which is contained in between the two pleural sacs, left and right pleural sacs, it is the mediastinal space, or it is known as the mediastinum. Mediastinum again can be divided into three parts. Suppose this is the anterior part of the animal, or the head end of the animal, and this is the tail end of the animal. Now, the mediastinum space which is facing the anterior part of the animal, it is known as the anterior or cranial mediastinum. And that part of the mediastinum which is situated at the middle part, it is the middle mediastinum. And the mediastinum which is situated towards the tail end of the animal, inside the thoracic cavity, and it is the caudal mediastinum or posterior mediastinum. Now this heart is located always in the middle mediastinal space. And this is the direction of the heart, it is always directed distally and towards the posterior side. That is, it is located obliquely, not in the vertical direction. It is always located obliquely in the thoracic cavity. Right? Now, the surface of the heart. So, this is the anterior surface of the heart. And this anterior surface is always convex. It is convex in shape. Whereas the posterior surface is, this is the posterior surface, this is flat or slightly concave. This is the This is the left surface and this is the right surface. Okay. Now before that, let me explain the pericardium. So this is the pericardium. And by the help of this pericardium, the heart is suspended freely in the thoracic cavity in the middle mediastinal space. This pericardium is attached dorsally to the bodies of the thoracic vertebra. This is attachment. Okay. And distally, after covering the heart, distally the pericardium is attached to the sternum. And this is the in case of dog, you will find two ligaments in the distal part of the heart. And that ligament is known as pericardiaco-sternal ligament. It attaches the pericardium to the sternum. It is known as pericardiaco-sternal ligament. So, in a nutshell, this heart is suspended by the help of pericardium inside the thoracic cavity. And inside the pericardium, there is a space known as pericardial space. Now, what is the pericardial space? You know, this pericardium is made up of two layers. One fibrous layer and one serous layer. And that too, one layer is the parietal layer and another layer is the visceral layer. Parietal layer is attached to the bodies of the thoracic vertebra and distally to the sternum, as I have already told you. And the visceral layer will be closely invested with the heart. And in between this visceral layer and the parietal layer, there is a substantial space and this is known as the pericardial space. And within this pericardial space, the heart suspends freely and it will pump freely inside this cavity. And the pericardial space is, filled with one fluid which is known as pericardial fluid or liquor pericardi. Okay. Now, this is the pericardium and this is the heart. You know, this externally if you see, the heart is covered with fat. These are known as the cardiac fat. Cardiac fat. Okay. Now, externally you will get certain grooves. There are three longitudinal grooves. This is one groove. This is another groove and this is another groove. These are the groups. These are the groups. They are known as the longitudinal groups. Okay. And one is the transverse groove. transverse means obliquely. So this transverse groove is known as, this is the transverse groove, this is the transverse groove, and this is known as the coronary groove, because this groove will lodge the coronary arteries and coronary veins. Coronary artery is the main artery which supplies the heart itself. And this is the transverse groove, and these are the longitudinal groups. This is the left longitudinal groove. This is the left longitudinal groove. Okay? And this left longitudinal groove will be touching the towards the apex. It will touch almost touch the apex. But this right longitudinal groove will never touch the apex. Okay? And this groove will inside correspond to the septum of the heart. Right? Okay. Now, the heart is a four-chambered organ. It has got four chambers internally. Internally, it will be having four chambers. But I will show you the internal of the heart in the next class, because it will be too big for you. Now, this is the exterior of the heart. Right? Four surfaces. First one is the anterior surface, always convex. Posterior surface, always flat or slightly concave. And this anterior surface will be facing towards the head end of the animal, and the posterior surface will be facing towards the caudal end of the animal. And this posterior surface will be touching the diaphragm, because diaphragm is the, you know already, I've only told you that diaphragm is the wall which separates the thoracic cavity from the abdominal cavity. It separates the thoracic and abdominal cavities. So diaphragm will be touching this flat surface, posterior surface of the heart. It will be touching. Now, you know, some great vessels, large vessels will enter and coming out of the heart. You can see these two great vessels. So this is the aorta. This is the aorta you must be knowing. Aorta is the major blood vessel of the systemic circulation. Blood will be pumped off of the heart through the aorta to different parts of the animal body or human body. So this is known as the aortic arc. Just like V-like structure, this is known as the aortic arc, right? Aortic arc, because in this arc, the aorta is divided into two parts. One is going to the anterior side of the animal or head end of the animal, and another side which is bigger as compared to this anterior part. This side is going to the posterior part of the animal. Hence, this is known as the anterior aorta, and this is known as the posterior aorta. Okay, this is the anterior aorta, or this is the posterior aorta, and this anterior aorta is also known as the common brachiocephalic trunk, CBCT. This is known as common brachiocephalic trunk or CBCT or anterior aorta. And this anterior aorta is responsible for supplying blood to the chest, thoracic limbs or forelimbs, neck, head and all, and in this region of the animal body. Whereas the posterior aorta will pierce through the diaphragm, that means it will penetrate the diaphragm, go to the abdominal cavity, then go to the pelvic cavity, and during its course it will supply all the organs of the abdominal cavity, all the organs of the pelvic cavity along with the abdominal walls and the hind limbs and tail. So it's very big one. You will know later in our subsequent classes. So this is all about the exterior of the heart. And this vessel, you can see this vessel, it's a large blood vessel, and it is known as the pulmonary artery. This is the pulmonary artery, and this pulmonary artery, you know already, I think you have done in your 10 plus 2 classes. This pulmonary artery will supply the impure blood to the lungs. Because, you know, arteries are always responsible for carrying the pure blood or oxygenated blood, except this pulmonary artery. So there is an exception, because this pulmonary artery will carry only the impure blood to the lungs. And pure blood after oxygenation from the in the lungs, pure blood will come from the lungs to the heart via the pulmonary veins. And this is the exception again, because all veins will carry impure blood from the body towards the heart, but the pulmonary vein will carry always the pure or oxygenated blood. This is the difference. Very important. Now, this is the auricle. I have told you that the heart is having four chambers, atrium, two atrium and two ventricle. And this is known as the auricular appendix. It's a part of the atrium. Two atrium, two ventricles. This is the part of the atrium. This is another, the auricle. This is auricular appendix of another atrium. So main important groove is this left longitudinal groove and right longitudinal groove. Always remember, right longitudinal groove is located on the posterolateral part of the heart, posterior right part of the heart, whereas the left longitudinal groove, which will touching the apex, which will be coming up to the apex, is located on the anterolateral side of the heart, or antero and left side of the heart. This is the groove, very important. And all the groups will be in live animals, all the groups will be filled with fat, always fat. And these groups, these left and right longitudinal group, will be connecting to each other at the apex. Because these groups, left and right longitudinal groups, along with the intermediate group, will carry the branches of coronary artery and coronary vein, which are responsible for circulation inside the heart. Okay? So this is all about the gross sections. Let me see in another heart. So this is the gross, this is the heart of pig. This is the heart of pig. Okay? Smaller in size. And this is the heart of small ruminants. Same. This is the straight posterior surface, convex anterior surface, left surface and right surface. And these are the great vessels. This is the posterior aorta. And this is the pulmonary artery. If I see this heart, it's an old one. So this is the anterior surface. This is the posterior surface, left surface and right surface. And these are the blood vessels. This is the anterior aorta or CBCT, and this is the posterior aorta, okay, supplying blood to the posterior part of the animal body. So this is the interior of the heart, and this will be covered in the next class. Thank you.